All right, this is Christian Robinson Music back again, and this is part two of the unboxing of my new Scarlett 2i2 interface. So I purchased the interface so that way when I record my live music videos that the audio would go directly inside my iPhone, which I'm using to record this video right now. So you don't hear me from the iPhone mic, you hear me from this mic going in to this mixer, and then this mixer goes into the Scarlett 2i2, and then that goes into the phone, and then that is how you're hearing me. So it's going to be a better, well, I compared the iPhone mic, which is not bad, with my regular mic. This is a Yeti. I didn't even list this in the initial setup, but it's a blue. I believe it's a, I'm looking upside down. It's a blue. I think it's a Yeti. I bought this for Zoom meetings for college, but I've already graduated, but I kept it here. So if I ever have a Zoom meeting, this is the mic that I use. But I also have microphones that go to the headphones that I don't use, so I could actually have the little small little microphone that goes to the headphone. It just attaches in. So I know you can't hear me clearly, because if I talk like this, then it would sound more clear. So you're basically hearing me from the room. All right, so the unboxing just showed you that I unboxed everything, right? So I've already unboxed, but I didn't want to go into trying to set everything up because the video would have been extremely long. So I'm going to go through what I did so far to make it work. Everything went perfect the way that I installed it. What took me more time is when I set up the second interface. And if you notice over here, that's the second interface. So that's the tablet. So that's what took so long. It's not setting up it to work with the iPhone. That was pretty simple. The Focusrite worked right away as soon as I connected everything. But my challenge was to find the right cables to connect to the tablet through another interface, which is the UR44. So I'm going to go through that. So I'm using two interfaces and a mixer. All right, so the Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 third generation USB interface is the interface that I chose to use. There are other interfaces. I even believe that there's a lower version of the UR44, like a UR2 or UR something with a 2 on there. So it's like a smaller version of this. And then there's another device that you could use, another brand. I chose that because I already have a Focusrite interface here. It's a larger one. It's a professional one. So you can barely see it, but you see it's the same color. So it's pretty much made the same way. So I have that. Then the Yamaha Steinberg UR44 USB interface. I was using this one before. Well, I was actually using an older Scarlett. I was using a Liquid 56 or something like that. It was an older one. It worked fine, but it has a different connection. I think it was FireWire instead of USB. So everything I have now is USB. I'm using FireWire for the monitor. This monitor is actually working. It's actually on. It doesn't have anything on the screen, but it's actually on right now. And then the Galaxy Tab S2, which is this. And that mount that I told you that I purchased, it's on the mount. I mean, I had the tablet sitting right here. And then I said, well, I might as well just put it on the mount, because you wouldn't have seen the mount with the way I was going to do the video. So the tablet would have been sitting right here. And I just recently moved it, you know, on the stand. So it's actually, I can move it further away so it doesn't block my view of this video, this monitor right here. So that's working out pretty well. The Tab S2. And then I have the Behringer Zenix 802 mixer. I never even said the model. I just bought this a long time ago and never even thought about the model, but it's a Zenix 802 analog mixer. So I had bought me a digital mixer. I bought a Zoom digital mixer, but I gave it away, and I have no problem with that. I'm not complaining about that. I'm planning on getting a larger mixer for the studio, but that's at another time. That mixer that I want is about $3,000 to $4,000, and the Zoom mixer that I purchased, I think it was somewhere either from $300 to $500. It wasn't that expensive. It's the 8, the L8 is what I have. You have the L8, you have the L12, and then you have the L20, and I believe that the L20 is $1,000, I think. I'm not remembering the exact prices, but you know, I like the Zoom products, but the faders did not move. They were not movable, so that's what discouraged me from getting that digital mixer. So this mixer is actually an analog mixer, but it worked out just fine. And we're going to talk about having a USB mixer. That was the other way of making this work, where I could have connected the USB straight to the interface and then go into the phone, and that would have worked as well. So you can work them together. So right now I'm working the mixer and this interface together, but it's not USB. Then I have the Sabrent 10-port power USB hub. So, you know, I find myself buying something, and then if I want it again, if I need another one of those devices, I buy them again. So, giving you an example, this microphone stand is a different mic. Every stand, there's only two that's identical. So this stand was made for this particular microphone. It came with the microphone, right? But it looks like my other stand. So I have another stand. You know, it's an arm, you know what I mean? And it rotates. And that's holding this particular cell phone. And then I just bought this one, which will hold a tablet or phone. And then I have another additional one, I think I showed in part one, that's on the other side on the other desk with my control surface. So I have a total of four that do the same thing. It just holds a phone or holds a tablet so I can record or whatever. But I'm repeating the purchase. I'm buying it again. I've done that several times with other products. So this power USB 10-port hub by Sabrent. I have another one. The first one, it's under in the back, Velcro to the back of all the device, you know, to this cabinet right here. And everything that has to do with music is connected to it. Everything. This one, there's nothing connected. It was just only for, let's just say podcasting or live videos. That so this will never be used for connecting the computer because it's isolated. Now, I probably can connect it to the computer, but my computer is doing a lot with USB, so I don't want to mess that up. And I'm very surprised that it's taking all the USB I have. I mean, I'm looking all around the room, and it has a lot of USB connected in some kind of way. So, yeah. So anyway, I have an iPhone. I believe I have the old one because I purchased mine right after it upgraded. So I think I have the iPhone 11. Software, I'm using BandLab to give tests. Like, that's what this one is. This one stopped recording? Why stopped recording? Did it reach a limit? I don't know. I have never used this program. So did we reach a limit? So let me try another track. But you did see that it was moving according to my vocal. So that was the only real reason why I had that. It may have a limit. It may only go so long, which is not a big deal. All right, so BandLab is what I'm using here. It's also on my iPhone. But this is not just audio, it's video. So I'm using the iPhone, you know, video recorder to record this video. And then I will upload it to YouTube. CC compliant, that was very important. I didn't read and I didn't pay attention, but it doesn't matter. This device is CC compliant, but only with Mac. So since I didn't buy it to connect to the Mac, I don't need any software or drivers to make it work. I can just connect it to the Mac and it would just work. I didn't even test it because I don't really care to connect this to the Mac, but like I said, they won't. It's no driver, so I'm using logic, and I'm sure that if I connect this to the computer, it will just see it, and then I can configure logic to use it instead of using the Clary Pre USB 8 that I'm using down here. So anyway, CC compliant means it needs no drivers. And I had to make sure it was that way, but I didn't pay attention. So that's why when I tried to connect my my tablet to it, it wouldn't connect. And I was like, man, I had just made it work the other day. The reason why it didn't work is because this one only works on a Mac compliant. And so that will... So I'm going to talk about the Steinberg. The Steinberg tested with both. I was able to use the iPhone and the tablet connecting this the other day with the test. So, you know, because it has a button in the back that says CC. I didn't even know what that meant for many years. And then I realized what that meant when I looked it up. So this guy, even though it's flashing, it's actually working or you wouldn't see the signal. So for some reason, when it's using the tablet, the light would be solid white if I was connected to the iPhone. This one would be solid white. But for some reason, it won't go solid white, but you see that it's clearly working. I think the reason why it stopped recording is because it's overheating. Right now, I turned off the fans, so you can hear how clear it is in here. When I have the fans on, it'll make it seem like it's noise, but there's little hiss. The hiss would be the mixer, because if it was a digital mixer, that noise floor would even be smaller, I believe. So that's exactly what I wanted. So if I be quiet, I could tell that the hiss, because I have the microphone all the way up, so it's picking up just a little bit of the, you know, the room tone, but that's good for that. But what you hear, any hiss you hear, if you can barely hear, is because of this mixer. And obviously the components as well, but it's very, very clean from when I tested it when I first got, when I didn't have this, and I tested it with this one, it was a lot of noise. It did work, but it wasn't as good as when I got this one. So that's the reason why I bought it. I figured it would work a lot better. All right, so the 2i2 is CC with only the Mac. So that's not a problem because I don't plan on using the tablet for this. I use the tablet for a control surface. I use it for a different purpose in the studio. So that doesn't bother me. But I have to make sure I read carefully because I saw that it was class compliant and that's all I went on. And it didn't dawn on me it's only class compliant with the Mac. All right, so looking at the actual device that I did the unboxing for, the 2i2, the INT button, I don't want to mess with it. Those are the instrument button. That's what I'm guessing, okay? Because I believe my other interface has that same type of thing. It's either saying, are you connected? Are you connecting an instrument or are you connecting a microphone? So it would work. It will, because it has a combo, so you can use an XLR or quarter inch. Right now I'm using 2 old quarter inches from the mixer into the interface, right? But it will work if you just use XLR or if you just turn instrument off, it'll still work. It's just going to be a little lower and not as clear. So that's why I turned the instrument on for both channels. Then you have direct monitor. So I'm listening in to the instrument. See, so I have three ways to listen. I could connect my headphones to the mixer and listen that way. I could connect my headphones to the Yamaha input device, the UR44, which is monitoring this right here. But I have it connected to the interface that's recording onto the iPhone right now. So you have mono and you have stereo. So I'm gonna push it to stereo. And it just got a little quieter, but it's in stereo now. So I'm gonna bring and now I can't hear it all. I can't hear it at all in the headphones. So now I can. So it's on mono and that's good if you want to hear the headphones. When I'm going to do what I'm going to do, I'm not even going to have the headphones on. I'm going to turn them off. I'm going to turn the headphones down, and I won't even have it connected because it's just going to be like me doing like I have normally been recording, but now the recordings are going to be clean instead of the room, because when I'm going to do my recording, I don't have to have this mic on anymore. And I'll explain why I did this last. All right, so then we have the 2i2, the 48-volt button here. It's off right now, so I just clicked it, but I'm going to turn it right back off. I don't need it. It's called phantom power. That's if your microphone like this one, it needs phantom power. But this mic is not connected to the interface. It's connected to the mixer. And that was what resolved another issue I'm going to get to next, which is mono. None of the videos address the mono issue. So hopefully this video will help people understand that using the mixer is a lot better. So anyway, 48 of a V, which I have it here, it says phantom power. But then under that, that light is always bright. I can't read. I think that number is 48. Yeah, it says the 48 on the light, on the red light on here, but it clearly says on the button phantom. And on this one, it just says 48 volts. And everybody who knows mixers know what that means. That means that if this microphone was plugged in to either device and I didn't have either button, either phantom power on, you wouldn't hear the microphone because it needs power. Just like this interface needed power. And that's another thing. That's the reason why I use the powered hub. Because this has no power connector. These type of small portable type. You have to get power through the USB. That's why I got that. I don't know if I'm sure I didn't explain that. But that's the reason why I got the powered hub. It's to power this device. Because nothing else needs that. Nothing else that I have over here needs power because everything is connected to the AC. Everything, you know, to the wall, okay? You know, DC, is it AC, DC? I believe alternating current, DC. I don't remember which one is what car or home, but they're all powered through the wall. This right here is not. This is powered going straight to the wall, but it's going to the phone. And the phone has its own power source. So anyway, if I didn't have that connected, this guy wouldn't be on if I didn't have this USB powered, okay? All right, so I resolved the mono issue by using a mixer. When I first did this the other day, everything worked when I only had the UR44. But I noticed it was only working on the left side, depending on what software you use or DAW. Like if you use GarageBand or if you use, you know, Logic or if you use any type of, device to record, then I noticed this thing, it probably overheated. So it turned off by itself because it was telling me that before. So I'm going to let that cool off. So basically, it was telling me, when I was playing it, I was only hearing on the left side because I only had the microphone connected to the first port. But if you connect it to the second port, which is right, then I would only hear things on the right. And I'm thinking, no, if I have a guitar and I have music, I was hearing the music on the right-hand side, and I was hearing my guitar on the left, depending on where you plugged it. But that's not what I wanted. I needed either be stereo or mono, meaning I needed the guitar to be on left and right, and I need the music to be on left and right, right? Or I needed everything to be mono, you know? So that's another reason why I bought this interface, thinking I was going to fix that problem. But it's not really a problem. It's like, it is a problem, but it's not. This mixer resolved that problem. As soon as I connected up, I could tell everything was going to work. But if you But nobody explained that on these videos. It shows that you have a signal, and obviously, you know, my my tablet overheated and it cut off. It's kind of warm. Yeah, it's warm. It's warm. And it was giving me a warning that it was overheating, so it basically shut itself off. So we'll see how that does when it comes back up. So anyway, so I was listening to the, you know, I was testing things, and I was noticing that I was only getting, you know, things on the left and the right hand side, and so the monitoring was on both headphones. I can hear good. It would be in stereo, the monitoring, the playing back. But when you played it back, yeah, the vocal would be on the left, and the music would be on the right. So I bought this interface thinking that would also resolve that issue, and I thought that it would give me better sound quality. So it gave me better sound quality, so it did that, but that is not what solved the mono problem, using the mixer. So once I went in from the left and the right, from the left and the right on the mixer, that is what gave me stereo. So right now, you might not hear stereo on YouTube. You might not hear it on Facebook. You may not hear it stereo, you know, on any of the social media sites. Even Zoom, I have it where I hear stereo on Zoom, like when you do Zoom meeting. But most of the time, they're using analog for a couple of reasons. It's faster, right? So stereo takes more processing. But when I'm listening to the music back in my headphones, or I'm playing music to it, I want to hear it in stereo. So that way, it sounds better to me. Even though you may hear it in mono, I still want to hear my playback in stereo. That's where this mixer comes into play. This is a very standard mixer. So this mic is a special mic. I've never seen a mic like this. It has a left and a right, okay? So, and they're independent from each other. So it's not a left and right. It's an actual just, you know, a red one and a black cable. And you can call it mono if you want to. But I have one going into the mix, this mixer, the analog mixer. And then I have one going into the interface. That's how I was able to make it go into here. Just for example, I only did this just as an example. Yeah, this guy's hot. You could just feel it hot. So once I connected, you know, that, and then it left me another open port here, which is good. And then on this port comes from my guitar, okay? Because that's what I'm doing all this for, is when I do live videos for TikTok or YouTube or for Facebook, I wanted my music to be clean. And I'm like, if people are using their cell phones, why are their audio sounding so clean using the microphone from the iPhone? It's because they're not using the microphone from the iPhone or their phone. They're using an interface, or they're using a mixer. Either one will get the trick done. And right now I'm using both. Okay, so let's say the first two channels are microphone channels because they have the XLRs, right? So I have two microphones. I can do whatever I want. So one is being utilized right now for this one, but I have an open mic. Let's say I wanted another mic to go to my headset. Like I said, I could connect it to this port too. And so three and four, meaning left and right. So three and four, one is going into the guitar out. Right, it's not really an out, but it's an effect out, mono. It's an effect out, so it's coming in. I use it all the time, so it works. It's been working for years, so I use that as a cheat out for my amp. I have another amp that has an actual out. It just says out, but this one, I use the effect out, and it sounds it has a little degradation, but it works just fine. And then to get the clearer signal, I'm using a microphone, a dynamic mic. It's not the best mic in the world. It's actually an old mic, but I'm using a quarter inch mic. So it's a cheaper mic, but it's connected to an XLR connector. And I put it in the back of the guitar. So it's not in the front to get the clear signal. it's actually in the back of the guitar, the amp. If I placed it in front, it will be a cleaner signal, but I'm happy with what I'm getting. So I can just, you know, replace the microphone and put it in front of the amp. I'm running out of space, so that's the reason why I just quickly did it that way. And then the next channel, I have the music coming in from the system. So the system is directly coming into the mixer, and I'll give you an example. So I'm gonna play. I'm not gonna play the guitar, but I'll play the music. So if I was playing that song, I would be able to play my guitar coming in on channel 3 and 4. And it works just fine. I've already tested it. So if you want to hear me do this, if you want to hear me play this, go ahead and look up part 3. Part 3 would be me making a video showing you that it actually works and that it's clean. And that, you know, most of my videos moving forward will be recorded this way, not just using the phone. Now, the phone wasn't bad. The problem that I found out with using the phone, it doesn't like the low end. The low end is really low, so I couldn't play the music really high. Right now, I can play, so what you just heard, the music is not coming outside the room. I have my headphones on. But the way that I designed it, I could have the music coming through the microphones lightly. Right now, I got the mic loud. But once I start recording, I'm going to back the mic down because I'm going to have the music coming out through and hitting this mic. So that's an example. So it's not overwhelming. It's going to give it a little bit more atmosphere, and you'll be able to tell that I'm using a room mic or a mic, but that doesn't bother me as long as the guitar is clean, and long as the music is clean. Then I accomplished my goal. So the music is gonna be clean, but this is not a master track. I didn't mix it. It might not sound perfect and clean, but the more, you know, I EQ it and make it sound, you know, better, then it's gonna sound way clean because I tested it out. It sounded good to me. So even if I take the music and just turn it down just a hair, my guitar is gonna sound like it's out in front. Remember, this is just playing around, you know, when you're making these TikTok videos, so the sound doesn't have to be totally 100% perfect. So the mixer solved the mono issue, and then obviously I can connect more things. This is only two channels, so I'd use it as a two channel left and right, but with the mixer, let's say I had a 20 channel mixer, then I can connect different. I can have somebody comes in. I have bass, so somebody with a bass can play along with it. So I can have 3 or 4 microphones connected to this, and people can sing, and it'll all be connected, and you can have other things coming in. But the reason why I'm using my old analog, because I don't expect to have a lot of connections, so this was just perfect. I wish it was digital far as the signal is concerned, but hear that? It's kind of clean. It's not really fuzzy. So, and then I have all the, you know, the volumes dialed in and the EQ dialed in way before I did the video. So I'm happy with it. Okay. Far as adapters, you need the Apple video camera adapter. I think I showed it in the first video. And if I didn't, I'll leave a description in the link. The key is it allows you to charge your phone while filming. You got to make sure you get the one that allows you to not just go USB in or USB. You need the one that also allows you to power, because once you connect it to your phone, then it's taking that port for the new phones, the iPhones that I have. You know, you can't charge the phone no more. You know what I'm saying? Once you put a accessory like this. This is an accessory. This allows you to use headphones, right? You know, audio. But once I connect that in, then I cannot charge my phone. My phone will not charge, you know. But in this case, now with the USB, the way that it is, I can charge my phone and video as long as I want. So this video went long enough. I basically showed you the unboxing of the interface and the powered USB. And I showed you my guitar picks, right? That was very exciting. And then my new tablet, and I showed that everything worked out. So if you have any questions, let me know. I'll try to put most of the elements in the description. I don't get paid from Amazon. If you buy it or whatever, if you click a link or whatever, I don't get paid from none of that. I don't have my YouTube set up that way. So, you know, I'm just going to provide you with the information, but you don't have to buy the exact thing that I got. You have to buy the stuff that works for you or whatever. I'm not making the suggestion, hey, you got to get a Focusrite or you got to use a UR44. Or, you know, you can make that on your own decision. But I've seen many videos like this, and they showed me what to do, and it worked perfectly. Just as it worked for them, it worked for me. All right, I'm out of here. Peace.